Hello everyone, my name is Dr. Zarifa Ramanova and today we will talk about vitamin B1 or thiamine. In the 19th century, two Dutch scientists observed that chickens fed white Polish rice developed leg paralysis, whereas chickens fed brown unpolished rice did not. So why did this happen to chickens and could this happen to humans? I will answer in this video. Thiamine or vitamin B1 is one of the water-soluble B vitamins. Thiamine plays a vital role in the growth and function of various cells, especially in the brain and heart. In the human body, as a result of phosphorylation processes, it turns into cocarboxylase, which is a coenzyme of many enzymatic reactions. Vitamin B1 is important for carbohydrate, protein, and fat metabolism, as well as in the processes of nerve stimulation in synapses. Thiamine accumulates mainly in the liver, heart, brain, kidneys, and spleen. Moreover, half of all thiamine is contained in striated muscles and myocardium. Thiamine deficiency could worsen health conditions in patients with heart failure. The findings of systematic review and meta-analysis of randomized double-blind placebo-controlled trials suggest that thiamine supplementation may benefit patients with heart failure. Thiamine supplementation improves left ventricle ejection fraction. This effect may be a result of thiamine's direct action on cardiomyocytes, improved energy production, and thus improved cardiac function. Additionally, thiamine supplementation in heart failure patients has been shown to improve blood pressure, urine output, and functional capacity of the heart. Some small studies have shown that oral supplementation with 150 to 300 mg per day thiamine can decrease glucose levels in patients with type 2 diabetes or impaired glucose tolerance. However, the authors of these studies did not assess the potential clinical significance of these findings. Nevertheless, both thiamine and its fat-soluble analog benfotiamine protect against the peripheral neuropathy that occurs in diabetes in humans. They both reduce advanced glycation end products. Benfotiamine is a better therapeutic than thiamine because it raises thiamine to much higher levels and for a longer period than does thiamine. The pharmacokinetics of benfotiamine has been well studied and it's very safe in humans. Nobel Prize-winning experiments in the 19th and 20th century associated with the discovery of thiamine revealed that a lack of thiamine in humans caused a common disease called beriberi, which includes a significant neurological component. Later, neurological components of beriberi were carefully characterized. Wernicke-Korsakoff mainly affected the central nervous system, Korsakoff syndrome, amnesia with additional psychiatric manifestations, and Wernicke-Korsakoff syndrome with both neurological and psychiatric symptoms. The syndrome is often complicated by alcoholism because alcohol reduces the absorption of thiamine. However, prisoners of the Japanese in the Second World War became thiamine deficient and had all the symptoms of Wernicke-Korsakoff syndrome in the absence of alcoholism. Early experiments in 1939 proved that subjects who received excess thiamine showed a recovery approximately 7 times as great as those that did not. Thiamine deficiency produces oxidative stress in neurons, death of neurons, loss of memory, plaque formation, and changes in glucose metabolism, all markers of Alzheimer's disease. Alzheimer's disease is defined by a progressive cognitive deterioration and neuropathological changes in the brain. Autopsy studies have shown that transcatalase and other thiamine-dependent enzymes have decreased activity in the brains of people with Alzheimer's disease. disease. Thymine has been implicated in neurological problems, delirium and dementia. Even though a role of thymine in neurological function has long been known, we have only a limited understanding of its multiple actions. More research is needed to determine whether thymine supplements might benefit people with different diseases. Humans stores thymine primarily in the liver, but very in small amounts. The vitamin has a short half-life, so people require a continuous supply of it from the diet. Bread, cereals, and infant formulas in the United States and many other countries are fortified with thymine. Dairy products and most fruits contain little thymine. Good food sources of thymine include whole grains, meat, and fish. Pork is another major source of the vitamin, but I do not recommend this type of meat. Why? I'll try to explain. Firstly, pork takes a very long time to digest in the human GI tract, about 5 to 6 hours. Secondly, pork is often infected with parasites, for example, trichinella, pork tapeworm, toxocara, and others, and all of them could stay alive during cooking, salting, and smoking. I mean, not smoking cigarettes, but the process of preparing food in smoky cooker. Because thymine dissolves in water, a significant amount of the vitamin is lost when cooking water is thrown out. Processing also alters thymine levels in food. For example, thymine presents in the outer layers of rice that are removed with polishing. The amount of thymine even in enriched with thymine white rice is 10 times less than in unenriched brown rice. This is the first part of my answer on the question, why did chickens fed white polished rice develop leg paralysis, cause of severe thymine deficiency? Vitamin B1 is readily degraded by heat treatment and other food processing methods. Other thymine breakers include caffeine, alcohol, air, water, estrogens, and sulfur drugs. The recommended dietary allowance for men aged 19 and older is 1.2 mg daily, and for women in the same age range, 1.1 mg daily. For pregnancy and lactation, the amount increases to 1.4 mg daily. Recommended amounts of thymine in other age group you can find in the dietary guidelines, link in the description box. A tolerable apple intake level is the maximum daily dose unlikely to cause adverse effects in the general population. Interestingly, there is no upper intake level for thymine due to a lack of reports showing negative effects from high thymine intakes. Levels of thymine in the blood are not reliable indicators of thymine status. However, we can use two ways for this purpose. The first one is indirectly measured by assaying the activity of the special enzyme transcatalase, which depends on thymine diphosphate TDP content in erythrocytes, red blood cells. The result known as the TDP effect reflects the extent of unsaturation of transcatalase with TDP and is typically from 0 to 15% in healthy people, 15 to 25% in those with marginal deficiency, and higher than 25% in people with deficiency. Another commonly used measure of vitamin status is urinary thymine excretion. These levels depend on dietary intakes but not tissue stores. It's worth pointing out that only small amounts are stored in the liver. That's why we could rely on this analysis. For adults, excretion of less than 100 micrograms per day thymine in urine suggests insufficient thymine intake, and less than 40 micrograms per day indicates an extremely low intake. Must people receive enough vitamin B1 through their diets? This is the reason why a severe thymine deficiency is rare in developed countries. The causes of thymine deficiency include insufficient intakes of thymine from the diet, low absorption or higher excretion rates than normal due to certain conditions such as following: chronic alcohol use disorders, low absorption of thymine in older adults, people with HIV infection, people with both types of diabetes, people who have undergone bariatric surgery. You will be surprised, but also people on a high carbohydrate diet. A thiamine deficiency can occur from certain medications like diuretics. In its early stage, thiamine deficiency can cause weight loss and anorexia, confusion, short-term memory loss, and other mental signs and symptoms, muscular weakness, and cardiovascular symptoms such as an enlarged heart. The most common effect of thiamine deficiency is beriberi, which is characterized mainly by peripheral neuropathy and wasting. And here is the answer on the second part of the question. Could humans fed white polished rice develop leg paralysis like chicken did? People with a thiamine deficiency have impaired sensory, motor, and reflex functions, as well as general weakness, unsteady gait, and leg paralysis. Refined rice contains an extremely low levels of thiamine and increases the body's need for it as well. In rare cases, beriberi causes congestive heart failure that leads to edema in the low limbs and occasionally death. This disease could be quickly cured by administration of supplemental thiamine, often parenterally. A more common manifestation of thiamine deficiency is Wernicke-Korsakoff syndrome. This disorder is about 8 to 10 times more common in people with chronic alcoholism than in the general population, but it can also develop in patients who have severe gastrointestinal disorders, rapidly progressing hematologic malignancies, drug use disorders, or acquired immunodeficiency syndrome, AIDS. Without treatment, up to 20% of people with Wernicke's encephalopathy die. Those who survive develop Korsakoff psychosis, although some people with Korsakoff psychosis have not previously had Wernicke's encephalopathy. Korsakoff psychosis, an effect of chronic thiamine deficiency, is associated with severe short-term memory loss, disorientation, and confabulation, confusion between real and imagined memories. At this chronic stage of the disorder, parenteral thiamine treatment does not lead to recovery in about one quarter of patients. The World Health Organization recommends daily oral doses of 10 mg thiamine for a week, followed by 3 to 5 mg daily for at least 6 weeks to treat mild thiamine deficiency. The recommended treatment for severe deficiency consists of 25 to 30 mg intravenously in infants and 50 to 100 mg in adults, then 10 mg daily administered intramuscularly for approximately 1 week, followed by 3 to 5 mg per day oral thiamine for at least 6 weeks. Consult your doctor to find your individual dosage. The body excretes excess amounts of thiamine in the urine. Because of the lack of reports of adverse effects from high thiamine intakes, 50 mg per day or more, from food or supplements, the Food and Nutrition Board, FNB, did not establish tolerable upper intake levels for thiamine. However, excessive intakes of thiamine could have adverse effects. Toxicity symptoms are rare. They could occur during intake of more than 400 mg per day and include lethargy, balance problems, intestinal problems. Thiamine is available in many dietary supplements. The most commonly used forms of thiamine in supplements are thiamine mononitrate and thiamine hydrochloride, which are stable and water-soluble. Thiamine is most effective in the B complex, being balanced with vitamins B2 and B6. Its action will be even more effective if pantothenic acid, folic acid, and B12 are included in this complex. According to Dr. Earl Mindel, the usual daily dose of B1 is 100 to 300 mg. Doses of vitamins B1, B2, and B6 should be balanced, that is, 50 mg B1, 50 mg B2, and 50 mg B6, so they work more effectively. The physiological function of vitamins B1 and B6 is to potentiate each other's action, which manifests itself in a positive effect on the nervous, muscular, and cardiovascular systems. Ethanol sharply reduces the absorption of thiamine. The concentration in the blood can decrease by 30%. Long-term treatment with anticonvulsants can lead to thiamine deficiency. Thiamine decomposes completely in solutions containing sulfides. Thiamine is unstable in alkaline and neutral solutions. A point with carbonates, citrates, barbiturates, copper preparations is not recommended. Vitamin B1 deficiency has become one of the most common manifestations of vitamin deficiency in all economically developed countries. One of the reasons is the widespread consumption of refined foods, sugar, white bread, refined rice, etc., which are poor in thiamine. Moreover, at the same time, these products increase the body's need for thiamine. Another reason for thiamine deficiency is the increased consumption of coffee and tea. Bear in mind that caffeine in coffee and tea destroys vitamin B1 in the body. If you are often bitten by mosquitoes, this may also indicate a thiamine deficiency. Vitamin B1 deficiency is easily prevented by dietary adjustments or prophylactic doses of thiamine. If you have any questions, write them down below. In the next video, I will talk about vitamin B2. Take care of your body and mind. See you!